fussy Frankie. Frankie was fussy. The little boy refused to eat any fruit or vegetable whatsoever. If any found their way onto his dinner plate, he would get rid of them immediately. Brussels sprouts would be flicked across the kitchen. Broccoli would be flung over his shoulder. Tomatoes would be splattered on the ceiling. Aubergines would be thrown back at whoever had the misfortune of serving them up. Rhubarb was the boy's absolute worst nightmare. Like a lot of fussy eaters, he never actually tasted the food he hated the most. But to Frankie, it looked and smelled yucksome. Whenever he came face to face with a piece of rhubarb, he took great pleasure in flushing it down the toilet. Goodbye, Ranky Danky Rhubarb! Good riddance! The boy would say as he watched it swirl down the pan. Every morning at breakfast time in the kitchen, Frankie's mum would plead with him.
You need to eat your five a day, Frankie!
The pair lived in a little house on the far side of town.
Casting a shadow over the family home was a huge nuclear power station that glowed in the dark and hung day and night.
Ma, I do get me five a day, snapped the boy. Crisps, biscuits, chocolate, cake and biscuits.
You counted biscuits twice.
That's because I have two packets a day.
Frankie's daily menu looked like this. Breakfast. A bowl of crisps with ice cream on top. Mid-morning snack. Sweets sprinkled with sugar. Lunch. Main course. A packet of chocolate biscuits dipped in chocolate sauce. Pudding. A deep-fried cake. Afternoon tea. A packet of double chocolate biscuits washed down with a glass of treacle. Dinner. Main course. A chocolate egg on a bed of crisps. Pudding. A block of fudge smothered in fudge sauce. A bedtime snack. A bag of toffees to chew on during the night. The boy's mum was sick with worry about her son. Because of his terrible diet, Frankie was becoming bigger, paler, and spottier by the day. So mum had decided to create a food revolution in her house. Her son was going to eat fresh fruit and vegetables at every meal, whether he liked it or not.
I'm starving! What's for brekkie, Ma? If it's not chocolate, then I'm putting myself up for adoption.